So when it comes to accessing a roof, there's multiple ways to do it. You can have your standard, the ladders extended up. You extend your ladder 3 feet above the eave edge. You secure the ladder to the building so that it can't move. You set it up at the proper angle so that it's not straight up and down. So setting up your ladder is the primary point of access. And you wanna set it up in a place that has steady ground, that's level. You know, sometimes you'll see it where you put a ladder in a landscaping and one side sinks in the mud. It's not a safe access point. So you wanna put those ladders in areas where it's safe, where it's solid, where it's level. And then on the roof, if it's a roof that has a pitch to it, you know, 5/12, 6/12, you can typically step onto the roof okay. You get up into the 7 and 8 and 10, 12 pitch roofs, you typically want to have a slide guard or something to be able to step onto so that you can be safely up on the roof and work from that way. But typically, most residential houses, you're setting your ladder up, you secure it to the building, and you make sure your extension of your ladder goes up 3 feet beyond the eave so that you're in compliance. And it also gives you something to kind of hold onto when you're stepping onto the roof or stepping off the roof onto the ladder at the same time. What I've seen where most falls happen is that step getting off the roof onto the ladder. For some reason, people are just not very comfortable stepping that way. And so making sure that the ladder is secured is really critical. In some roof applications, you will have what's called a roof hatch. It's a roof access point that you can climb up from the inside of the building. You can open the handle and it opens up the roof of the hatch. And so that gives you a good access point. Most of the time you'll find those on commercial jobs. So part of our policy in our company is that if we have a roof hatch on a job, we set up a perimeter that goes around that hatch approximately 6 feet, at leaving one point open for an access point. But what we'll also do is if we're gonna be on the job for the day, nobody's gonna be working in that area, we'll close the hatch so that we don't have that open exposure at all. And so getting out of those roof hatches sometimes is the most dangerous part. If it's an older building where they did not install one of the extendable handles that are now available, or if it's one of those types that doesn't have the perimeter around that hatch. But getting out of the hatch is sometimes you're having to, you climb up the ladder and then you grab the top of the hatch and then you're stepping up and you don't have anything else to hold on to. So what we try and promote with our customers is to install those extension poles that you can put inside the hatch. You get to the top of the, you know, get to the top of the ladder and you can grab the handle and pull it up and it locks in place and it gives you something to hold on to when you climb up out of that hatch.